The biggest challenge in putting together this segment every week is that if you want to talk about misogyny, you're going to find yourself talking about violence against women, which is hard to talk about for most people one way or the other, but it's especially hard to talk about in the context of a comedy show. Because let's face it, violence against women is never funny, even when the violence comes in the form of duct taping a woman up and drawing penises on her, which is definitely not funny. Unfortunately for the idiot that did it, that didn't stop him from citing the hilarity of the whole thing as defense against accusations of battery. According to police, Zachary Shelton tried to excuse himself from kidnapping, domestic abuse, unlawful transaction with a minor, and harassment with physical contact by explaining that it was all in good fun. And by the way, in case you're wondering how the unlawful transaction with a minor wound up in there, while she was duct taped, he encouraged their son to draw a dick on her as well. This story pisses me off on so many levels, obviously. And while the physical and psychological trauma the victim went through is at the top of the list, I'm also pissed off on a professional level that someone would use dick jokes for the powers of evil. I guess all we can do is hope that Zach winds up in a prison full of inmates with a sense of humor similar to his own. So for the record, in case I didn't make this perfectly clear before, I'm 100% against duct taping people and drawing dicks on them. Although I have to admit that if there was an exception, and there's not, but if there was, it might just be Kansas Governor Sam Brownback, who explained that denying women access to contraceptive care was all part of his recipe for economic growth in Kansas. Still angry over having a surname that arose due to his family's genetic propensity for spastic ass-wiping techniques, Brownback explained that banning abortions after 20 weeks just made good economic sense, damn it. Quote, "One of the big problems we have in this country is that we're not forming enough families, and that is hurting our economic work." End quote. So yeah, the big problem in America is the underpopulation. Got it. Must be why Brownback is so pro-immigration, huh? Wait, what's that? He's exactly the opposite of that? Fuck it. I guess I can at least commend him for not comparing abortion to slavery, which he did do in his 2014 State of the State address. And finally, tonight I want to nominate Lebanese TV host Rima Karaki as my ovarian badass of the week. I wanted to talk about this story last week, but we had the whole International Women's Day thing going, and I figured one way or the other Karaki would still be a badass this week. So what earned her the honor? Well, while conducting an interview on Lebanon's Al Jadeed TV, she got fed up with her guest rambling like a drunken uncle's family reunion confessional and politely asked him to hurry it along and get to the point. At which point he completely lost his shit and acted like she just demanded a fucking testicle. After telling her to shut up, demanding that he be respected, and telling her that it was beneath him to be interviewed by a woman, he told her in no uncertain terms that he would talk about whatever the hell he wanted to talk about, and he'd talk about it as slowly as he cared to. And while she had to admit she couldn't stop him from babbling, she could damn sure stop broadcasting it. After trying fruitlessly to get him to shut up long enough for her to explain that the commercial break is a couple minutes away, whether or not the person who tells him that has a penis, she cut his mic and quite badassedly ended the segment by explaining that there was going to be mutual respect or there wasn't going to be an interview. Go Rima. So, with a rare chance to end this segment on a high note, until next time, I'll hand things back over to Noah and Heath.